To open up all those big box goodies, local deputies want you to think twice about putting those containers at the curb. They say those are just the kind of things that the bad guys are looking for this holiday season. WESH 2's Bob Keeling joins us live in Orange County with more on a new initiative called Operation Burglar Box to help protect you from home burglars. Bob, how does this all work?
Yeah, Jason, you wouldn't think of these recycling bins as crime-fighting tools, but actually, they're going to be going up all over the county, so you've got somewhere to put these big electronics boxes, and you don't end up putting them at the curb and making them a calling card for bad guys.
It's the bad guy shop, just like we shop, and so if you put that nice big flat-screen box, that 60-inch box out there, they're going to come by and go, oh, that's nice, I wouldn't mind picking one of those up.
Throughout Orange County, these recycling containers are appearing as part of a new crime-fighting initiative, Operation Burglar Box. Throughout the holidays, Orange County deputies want you to know that you can take your empty big box containers here rather than leaving them as a crime calling card in front of your house. So what should you put in them?
Any of the big flat screen boxes, the large PSP or PlayStation or gaming system type things, a lot of the high-end computer stuff, any of those large ticket boxes where if you left it out on the side of the road, people would say, oh, that's nice, I might want to come by and get one of those.
Captain Jeff Stonebreaker says 37% of the crime he sees in his sector is home burglaries. Through Operation Burglar Box, he says he hopes to close the lid on that holiday trend. Now, the first three of these are already out here on the west side. This one is at Pine Hills in 50. And over the coming days, there's going to be about 8 of them total around the county. If you'd like a complete list of where they're going to be, just check out WESH.com. Reporting in Pine Hills, Orange County, Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.